अस्सलाम वालेकुम। एंड गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू शुजात अली? याद अली, कैन यू लिसन मी?
Yes, sir, I am fine, sir.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning to you, sir.
Okay. Today we have to start a new briefing. How many briefings we have done, Shujat?
Five, sir.
Five. Today I have to start new briefing on ceremonies, okay? Ceremonies.
Okay, sir.
Let you note it now. Ceremonies. Main points. Definition. Importance. Types or kinds. Four. Problems, benefits, suggestions, point of view. Let us start briefing on ceremonies. Definition of ceremonies: it is gathering of people for specific purpose. It's called ceremony. It is gathering for special purpose. It's called ceremony. People, you know, have to participate and go together to participate in any party. So it is called ceremony. It is collection of people for specific purpose is called ceremony. The definition of ceremony. Second point, importance. Why ceremonies are important for us? First of all, any man, any person is social animal. Nobody can survive without society, because people are helpless alone. Everybody have to need in different matters. Everybody need help in different matters with different persons or and with other people. It is impossible to stay alone in the society for any person. It is obligatory that he have to make connections with different people regarding different matters. There are many personal matters, financial matters, social matters. Nobody can deny the importance of ceremonies. Ceremonies are part of our lives. Ceremonies play a major role in our lives. Ceremonies have great importance in our lives. Ceremonies are very important for our lives. Nobody can ignore to ceremonies. Ceremonies are obligatory for our lives. Ceremonies are compulsory for our lives. Ceremonies are most important for our lives. Ceremonies are most important for our survival. Nobody can alive or survive without ceremony. Types or kinds of ceremonies. There are many types of ceremonies. There are many kinds of ceremonies. There are numberless types of ceremonies. There are countless kinds of ceremonies. There are a lot of types of ceremonies. There are a lot of kinds of ceremonies. There are too much types of ceremonies. There are too much kinds of ceremonies. First of all, I talk about religious ceremonies. In all religions, people have to participate in ceremonies according to their religions. In all religions, there are religious ceremonies are found. And mostly people have to participate in the religious ceremonies according to their religions. In all over the world, people have to manage to religious ceremonies and participate a large number of people in those ceremonies. There are numberless religions in the world, and according to numberless religions, people have to participate in different religious ceremonies and participate in the religious ceremonies. Other part of ceremonies, our festivals. In all religions, people have to celebrate their festivals. It is also gathering in festivals for enjoyment purpose. People have to feel happiness and people have to participate with full arrangements. People have to prepare for their festivals. There are two main types of ceremonies. First ceremony, now like people have to enjoy those ceremonies like marriage ceremonies, birthday ceremonies, farewell ceremonies, welcome ceremonies. Official ceremonies. Marriage ceremonies are very common in the world. A large number of people have to participate in the marriage ceremonies. Mostly relatives have to participate in the marriage ceremonies. A large number of relatives have to participate in the marriage ceremonies In birthdays, ceremonies, mostly relatives have to participate, and mostly friends and cousins have to participate in the birthday ceremonies in all over the world. There are official ceremonies like welcome ceremony, farewell ceremony, promotion ceremonies. In this kind of ceremony, only official people or office colleagues have to participate in these ceremonies. I talk about official ceremonies. Senior and juniors, office colleagues have to participate in this kind of ceremony. Somebody joins to office, so all office colleagues, juniors and seniors, have to welcome to new office colleague. It is welcome ceremony. People have to manage this ceremony. Office colleagues have to manage this ceremony. And only staff participates in this kind of ceremony. Same here in farewell ceremony, same here. All office staff participates. If somebody gets retirement from office and somebody have to change the job and he spends much time in any office, so in the honor of going person, farewell party or ceremony is managed, and all office colleagues have to manage this party, same farewell party. Now I talk about mourning ceremonies. Allah forbid somebody dies in the situation of mourning environment, somebody dies. So then mourning ceremonies have to take place in this situation. Mourning ceremony. Anybody looks sad in this kind of ceremony? People have to weep if somebody dies. People have to participate in the sad environment. Everybody looks sad. So a large number of people have to participate in mourning ceremony. First of all, relatives have to participate in this kind of ceremony or in this type of ceremony. On the other hand, our friends, office colleagues, people have to belong from different classes, have to participate in mourning ceremony. Because person who is died had many relations with different people. So mostly people have to belong from different classes, have to participate in mourning ceremony. Now there is also a very important ceremony. People have to celebrate ceremonies to picnic spot. People have to go to picnic spot. People have to celebrate their birthday parties on picnic spots. Even official meetings are managed to picnic spots. These are all ceremonies have to participate, these kind, mostly ceremonies have to manage to picnic spots. They also, it is also very common nowadays. So these are prominent, I told you about prominent ceremonies in the world. Our national days in all over the world, in every country has national days. So then independence ceremonies are managed in all over the world. Different countries have to manage to Independence Day in the form of ceremony. National days, Defense Day. Like Mother Day, Father Day, Education Day. Same here, as I mentioned you, mostly ceremonies are managed as a national days. If any leader, in the memory of any leader, different countries have to celebrate different ceremonies like birth ceremony, death ceremony. So people, it also collection of people regarding this ceremony. Mostly birthday parties are organized and ceremonies are managed to picnic places, to historical places. Mostly people have to go to other city and manage and participate different type of ceremonies. Mostly people leave the country and go to foreign countries to participate in the ceremonies. Mostly relatives live in abroad. Mostly people live in the foreign countries. A large number of people have to move to other country. They have to get visa from embassy. Same here, from other countries, people have to come to Pakistan for participate in the different types of ceremonies. Many international tours are managed to participate in different ceremonies. So we can divide to ceremonies in two basic parts: domestic ceremonies or international ceremonies. Then if we go in the depth, then we have to find numberless ceremonies, numberless types of ceremonies. Same here, if any kid bonds, any baby bonds, so there also people, parents have to manage ceremony. I talk about the Muslims, Akika ceremony. In all over the world, people have to also manage ceremony regarding birth of baby. According to their religion, they have to organize their ceremonies. They also, I can't ignore it now, like people have to, mostly people have to manage, in all over the world, people have to manage Teacher Day as a ceremony. Teacher Day, Father Day, Mother Day, Environment Day, Peace Day, etc. So there are numberless types of ceremonies in all over the world. Now, next point, problems. What problem people have to face regarding different ceremonies? First problem, how many people have to invite in any type of ceremony? According to that, proper place is required. On the other hand, we have to manage breakfast, lunch or dinner. What we have to do? Further, we have to decide about expenses. What expenses should be? How much expenses should be? Where to take decisions? Many things are required, many items are required. We have to manage the ceremony in any hall or in any open place. If we have to organize to any ceremony in open place, so we need many tents, many chairs, many tables, crockery, we need crockery. We have to manage breakfast, lunch or dinner according to need. We need how many items we have to manage these problems. On the other hand, we have to decide about time. What time we have to organize any ceremony? On the other hand, very important thing now, people should be united. Most people are not united and start quarreling and disputes at a time of ceremonies. Somebody says, no, I think we must do it. Other person say, no, you should do according to my thinking. Then many quarrels and disputes take place. And many ceremonies are disturbed. And the environment looks disturbed. So most people can't enjoy two ceremonies. Further problems that if we have to invite two people, approximately we have to invite 500 people in any ceremony. I don't talk about any marriage ceremony or birthday ceremony or any type of ceremony. Just we have to send 500 invitations, but people have to come above 1,000. So all ceremony arrangements are disturbed in this situation. No proper arrangement for sitting. No, people can't manage the breakfast, lunch or dinner according to the situation, because the lunch was managed for 500 people, or breakfast was managed for 500 people, or dinner managed for 500 people, but double number of people participated in any function. So as a result, our managements, all things are flop in this situation. So as a result, many complexities and or complications take place. Many tensions take place in this situation. Then minor problems have to change in major problems. In this situation, minor problems change in the main problems. On the other hand, people have to come too late in different ceremonies. For example, the ceremony time is a 2 p.m. but people have to come in the evening time. The time of ceremony was 2 p.m. but people come in the evening time. People have to come after 2 or 3 hours. So in this situation, all ceremony is disturbed. Some people are very punctual. They have to come in time in any ceremony. Then many quarrels and disputes take place in this situation. Because some people are punctual and they have to get punishment. Why those people came punctual? Because it was not their fault. If people are punctual, then they have to blame to those people. Why you came late? Most probably, host can complain or complain to late coming people. So other guests can mind that you insulted us, so they go back at home. Then many quarrels and disputes take place in this situation. Many problems they have to create in the presence of this situation. Next point, benefits of ceremonies. First of all, people have to get much knowledge by exchange of views. People have to understand to each other. Then unity have to take place. The unity takes place by exchange of views among different people. Mostly people have to make good friends in ceremonies. Different people have to belong from different classes. Different people have to belong from different professions. So people have to get many benefits by cooperation. And mostly people have to solve their problems in different fields. And people have to help to each other. These are benefits. On the other hand, people can release their tensions in the ceremonies. People have to discuss about different matters and issues and solve their problems. If there are some complexities or if some people were upset. So by dialogues, some people have to participate. Some wise people have to participate. And clear the misunderstandings in different people. Suggestions. First of all, regarding manage to any ceremony, who should select to wise people, who should select to genius people for supervision of any ceremony? Because wise people and genius people can manage well to all ceremonies. Then we can avoid from many complexities or many complications. Because it happens that mostly managements are given to irresponsible people, not responsible people. People have to trust on irresponsible people or not responsible people, not wise people, not genius people are selected for manage to all things. I am talking about arrangements of any ceremony. As a result, many problems have to take place. The best suggestion, we have to select wise people, genius people, cool-minded people, and experienced people for manage to any ceremony. We have to make the team of wise, genius, cool-minded, and experienced people as our team for manage to different ceremonies. Best suggestion. On the other hand, people should be punctual. Everybody should come in time in any ceremony. Then people can avoid from many queries and disputes. On the other hand, people should come according to number. It is not fair, it is unfair that if any host invites to just one guest from one home, but person have to participate with whole family in any function or in any ceremony. It is unfair. Then all managements, all manage things can disturb in this situation. We should take care about host. We should think about his arrangement. Maybe he managed all things according to 500 people or 1,000 people. But we should care about him. We should think about host. Suppose any host invited me, just me. So I should participate only me. I should participate only one from my family. I should not invite two other family members. Yes, okay, I have to go in my ceremony. And you come with me. Oh, there is very fantastic lunch and dinner. It is unfair. On the other hand, I talk about crockery, I talk about tents, I talk about, management, about arrangements, about lunch, dinner, or breakfast. Everybody should be punctual. And everybody should be committed with his work. It is very important. We need teamwork. We have to united. We should be united in this situation by strong communication. All ceremonies can get the extraordinary success. And everybody can enjoy the ceremonies. In the end, my point of view is that if we have to manage any ceremony, first of all, we have to get suggestions from different people. In advance, we should be ready regarding managements of any ceremony. We have to ask from different people. We have to get different suggestions. Then we have to take decision from ourselves. We should not be disturbed. We should not be confused. We should not take any decision in a hurry. We need patience in many decisions. We should be cool-minded. We should trust on Allah. On the other hand, if we think that we have to arrange for 500 persons in any ceremony, so it is much better. We have to arrange for 700 persons. Maybe extra persons can come, extra people can come in the ceremony. Then we can avoid from many problems and many complications or complexities. In the end, very important point as a point of view, everybody should be punctual. Everything will be okay. I have to close my briefing on ceremonies here. Yes, Yadali, did you get my all points nicely?
Yes, sir.
So, how much you picked today?
About 60%, sir.
60%. 50 or 60?
60, sir. About 60.
Above 60, but that's good. Not bad. Also, you have to, tomorrow, you have to come to academy. Are conscious about it?
Yes, sir. I know.
Same time, class time is same. You have to come 11 a.m. in the class, no? And you need much practice. Tomorrow, I will ask you in the class about it now.
Yes,
start question answers regarding ceremonies as per your presentation. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Today's lecture will upload to YouTube, and you can get lecture from there as usual. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I think you have not any question,
sir. No, sir.
No. Okay. Inshallah, we will meet again tomorrow in the academy. So, class is going to end now. God bless you. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Same here, sir. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you.